Hey, I'm Alex Vega. Welcome back to God Eater Appreciation. We're playing the game that was one of the games that was announced for localization yesterday, God Eater Resurrection. And like I said yesterday, this is an import of the Japanese version. Now, unfortunately, unlike some imports, this doesn't have English subtitles, so I kind of didn't really luck out there, but I wanted to play it as much as possible. Originally, my plan was to just play it alongside my PSP version and just hope they line up, yeah, contextually. But I just... Ooh, I got, what's his face? Sakuya. What I mentioned in the cut part of this recording is that in some missions you can choose your party members. I think that's only in some of the side missions. Otherwise, you have required members that you get in the story missions. I haven't gotten too far. Yeah, it's a post-apocalyptic Earth in a pretty distant future, where the Aragami are pretty much ruling over these over society. And this is my cute little waifu. Oh wow, they actually improved the lip syncing too. There's like the lip syncing was like all like 2D lip syncing in the PSP version, which I mean you can't really expect too much from the PSP version, right? They added a few other things to this version of the God Eater, including improved mechanics. I think they added a few new weapons as well, because in the original one, you had various choices of swords. Your weapon is called the God Arc, and it could transform between like a sword or some kind of variation of a sword and a gun or a cannon. And I think it added some weapons from God Eater 2 as well, I'm pretty sure. Because I know God Eater 2 added like a hammer, a lance, and various other weapons. I think there's a few other weapons in the enhanced port that we're playing right now. Unfortunately, I don't know what her objective is. I haven't played the PSP version in preparation of this just yet, unfortunately. I should have, but I did not. But the story missions all involve hunting Aragami, and let's see, they don't tell me what kind I need. Alright, there's one. Oh, it's one of those guys that fucked me up yesterday, I think. Alright, let's fuck him up. How do I run? How do I run faster? Hold on. I know there's a way you can sprint. Oh, you hold R1. There we go. No, it's not the same guy, it's a different guy. These guys are a little annoying in Project Cross, so I remember these guys. So you got your basic light and heart attacks, similar to Monster Hunter. This is my light chain right now. Done with square, and your hard chain's done with triangle. Now, I guess I'll show a little bit. Is this guy dead? Alright, you can consume them and give materials. I think he may actually be dead. Oh, he's still getting numbers coming out of him. He might not be dead yet. You could change your weapon's form as well. Oops, wrong one. Hold on. I guess he's dead. Oh. Yeah, there you go. The Abyss consumed him. Alright. Personally, for me, since I'm not really good at this game just yet, I don't really know when you would want to switch between your cannon and your sword. I mean, besides obvious range differences. This guy, he's gonna get... Oh, shit. Damn it. I don't know why I keep hitting R1. He's gonna get a face full of lead. Too bad you can't really lock on. It's more free aim. Yeah, your guns do have various ammunitions. I actually forgot how to check, because I can't read Japanese. But you can refill it by consuming your enemies or eating them using your God Arc. How come I'm not locked on? I have to hold it, never mind. I have to hold L when to lock on. Nice, I completed the mission. My character's going the wrong way. I think there's some emotions you can display in this game, but I might be thinking of another game. I forget. My character's all cool. Yeah, so you can consume enemies to get various upgrading resources from them. I'm pretty sure it's like other materials as well that you can sell. But holding R1 gives you a different set of maneuvers that I'm pretty sure wasn't in the original God Eater. So holding R1 and the light attack gives you this like somersault uppercut, and holding R1 and your heart attack gives you the consume ability. In the original God Eater for the PSP, you actually had to charge your consume in order to use it. You couldn't just, you know, combo into it. You couldn't just throw it out there on a whim. But this is a really early mission. In fact, I think that's the second ever story mission. So they're generally pretty short, and they're generally pretty easy. But once you get to like some of the bigger Aragami, obviously get harder. There is a sort of set time limit. And a few of them do quite a bit of damage, so you will die, but it's not like you lose progress either. You respawn like shortly thereafter, but you do get like a score penalty. You have to come here to get new missions, so let me see what I can do. Let's see. Oh, looks like there's no more story missions just yet. I'm gonna finish all these side missions then. I don't want to do a... Okay, I did all the training missions already, sweet. Yeah, because those are kind of boring. I can customize my party. Sick. So I'll have Lindo, who's romanized as Rindo. And I don't know who Anna is, or Federico. That's gonna be my party for now. Generally, as far as I know, I don't think there's a penalty for adding more people to your party. It definitely does help. You do want the firepower, especially since like characters like Sakuya specialize in healing bullets that she can shoot at you from afar. You do have your own set of items you can use as well, but I can't really read them. I can guess from the pictures what they are, but there's like a syringe. I forget the actual localized name of it was. There's a syringe that you can use that'll heal you. And there's like a healing, healing AoE item. Wait, where am I going? Come on, how do I pull up my map? Nope. How do I pull up my map? Alright, hold on. I'll figure this out. There we go. All I had to do is add options. It looks like our target's over here in Sector E. Now, like I said, I guess I mentioned it briefly in my Tales of Assyria DLC video. Damn it, you don't want to get a heart attack in the air. I mentioned briefly, but this game, oh wow, that was easy. it's more aesthetically pleasing to me than Monster Hunter. I like the playstyle a little bit. It's faster. It's more actiony. It doesn't feel as clunky. I'm not a fan of like mindless gore and blood. I mean I'm not as much as I used to since I was a kid, but this game, I just like a sci-fi setting more so than a fantasy setting with gameplay like this, I guess. Because I just did get Freedom Wars. It's free on PS Plus for this month. And, I don't know. Maybe, okay, I shouldn't say that I don't really like medieval settings, because I'm the guy who plays Dark Souls, too. I guess I didn't really like Monster Hunter's controls. It did feel clunky, felt sluggish. And I know it's probably intentional, because you're not supposed to be like a super cool action hero guy. But I don't know, I just don't like games with clunky controls. I do really like the aspects of Monster Hunter. I just couldn't really get into it. I have it for the Wii U. I think I still have it anyway, but I'll probably give it another honest shot at some point. What do we do? How are we doing on time? Alright. It looks like I got time for a few more missions. Oh, I got mail. I should probably check that. Not that I can read it. But it might be stuff. They might give me stuff. Yeah. Oh, I didn't get a good look who Anna was either. I'm just gonna check my mail for completion's sake. Oh god, there's a bunch of mail. Yeah, one thing that gets you that you have to really get used to for import games, especially from Japan, is that O is the confirm button, or circle is the confirm button, and X is the cancel button, which took a fair amount of getting used to. Unless you're a regular importer, I know Epic Name Bro does. He says he's more used to He's more used to the Japanese PlayStation controls because he used to live in Japan, but it takes a little getting used to. It makes sense too that circle would be confirm and X would be like deny or something. It's a weird thing that they wouldn't bring that over to the United States or something. I have no idea why they didn't do that. But anyway, let's go ahead and do our next mission. Oh no, I gotta get out. No, I gotta get out. That's a little interesting thing too. I was just reminded of that the icons on the PlayStation face controller do have meanings. Like circles confirm. X is deny, square was something, and I think triangle was supposed to be menu, or one, maybe the opposite, or something like that. Like, they had various, like, hieroglyphic meanings. Looks like we're going after another Iron Tail here. These guys aren't particularly hard, but if you let your guard down, they will mess you up in packs, man. Fuck you. I haven't found a purpose for that gliding attack. That gliding... Oh, wow, that was easy. that jumping attack... Oh, there's more. Shoot. Oh no, they found me! There he is. He's pissed. This attack right here, I couldn't find a purpose besides gaining ground. That was it? He's dead already? I thought they were slightly harder than that. Huh, well that's disappointing. Well, that's not the end of the mission. There's still another... Ooh, there's a big one over there? Alright, gonna have... Oops. Oh, whoa, I didn't mean to do that. There's another big guy on the far side, it looks like. But let me take care of this one. I'm pretty sure our objective is to eliminate all these ogre tails. I'm pretty sure consuming does a lot of damage as well. Actually, let me see. Oh, maybe not. Consuming does... it does only okay damage. Now, if you've... Ooh! Is that a Vajra? Shit, it's a Vajra, dude. Vajra's hit hard. Last I checked, anyway. I'm gonna take care of the Iron Tail because he's the... Yeah, no, that's not good. Munch him. I got something from him. Oh, I forgot. When you consume them while they're alive, you get like a power boost. Your ammo change. You get like a special ability. I think it's... From what I've seen, it's only for your gun. So I'm gonna go ahead and switch to that real quick. Oh, I can... I got a healing bullet. I can... Ah, shit. Get off of me. You, there is some limit of friendly fire in this game. Okay, so R1 and square are your special heavy bullet. I feel like I got rapid fire off of this thing. I'm not doing a whole lot of damage though. So, oh yeah, I remember now. Square and triangle. I'm out of ammo, it looks like. Square and triangle just change what kind of bullets you have. It doesn't change strength. Ah, shit. What, we've won? Oh, we didn't have to kill the Badra. Oh, okay. We only have to kill all the Ogre Iron Tail guys. The Badra, they hit pretty hard. I continued that Tales of Zestiria playthrough off camera yesterday, and I had to fight several of them. They took a hell of a long time to beat in that game, and they take a kind of a long time to beat in this game too, at least in the PSP version. I hope they didn't lower the difficulty in this game, because that was actually pretty fun to deal with. I think I got new missions, don't I? I do not. What the H? Ooh, what do I do now? Maybe... What's this? Oh, there's more missions. Oh. Okay. There's more missions here. I don't know what missions these are. In fact, I can't even select them. There might be some kind of DLC missions or bonus missions. I can't select them. I don't know. Oops. Let me back out real quick. See what I can do. Maybe I missed something? Is there... I didn't miss anything. Maybe I gotta talk to some... Oh, you know, I probably have to talk to someone first. But I think we're getting kind of close to time here. Yeah, we're getting a little close to time. I wasted 6 minutes, but I'm gonna make that up in just a bit. Yeah, between missions, from what I remember, you have to go to like, certain people's... Ooh, shoot, what you want me to say? I may have to go to someone's office. Let me figure that out real quick. Luckily, because there is some English in this game, you can sort of figure out where to go. I guess I don't have to go here yet. Maybe I gotta go to the lab. I actually guessed. I didn't know that was gonna be the lab. Nope, don't gotta go here. Oh, why are people sending me... Oh, I don't need emails, man. Stager floor? Is this it? Oh, hey. Maybe I gotta talk to Lindo? Lindo. Okay, maybe not. Sakuya again? Maybe I'll say this one. I don't know what she wants me to say. Oh, I don't know. I like the little absent-minded look I gave to my character, though. It's funny. I wonder if I can look at my character. Oops. Maybe I can get a good look at my character real quick. Yeah. Oh, shoot. What did I do? Oh, no. Oh, I tried changing my message. No, back out. Back out. Yeah, and I had to put the thank you for playing, Oh, that walk cycle. The thank you for playing message on there. You can change your armor, but I'm not exactly I can't read. I can't read Japanese, so I don't know. This is my room. You can go to access this terminal, but I don't know if it does anything special. I think it's the same one you have upstairs, just maybe it's other stuff as well. Oh, this is embarrassing. If only I knew how to... Oh, what am I doing? Uh-oh. What is this? Oh, that's neat. I didn't know that existed in this game. But yeah, like much like I should mention, though, much like Monster Hunter games, there is multiplayer. It looks like you can hook up with friends. I guess I'm just gonna go back upstairs. I imagine this game is much more fun with friends, but it also doesn't feel like it doesn't feel boring on your own either. What the heck? How do I? Oh, here's another one. Sweet. I guess I did have to go down there. All right, so we'll do this one. We'll do one more. Oh, I'm paired up with Soma. That guy's a dick. So if you watch the anime, you know that Soma's kind of a he's kind of a dick. I mean, I don't know. The anime is on a hiatus right now. It's coming back this month, I think. But, it's actually pretty good. I like it. Oh, that guy's super dead, I bet. Oh, isn't that the guy who gets eaten in the anime? I don't remember this being in the PSP game. Jeez, dude, how many times can you flip your hair in one sentence? That's three. Oh, man. Oh, he's fucking dead. Shit, man. Damn. I guess I should shed some light on the story of the game, from what I remember anyway, and from the anime. But you are a god eater. That's part of the organization you're a part of, and you hunt down these Aragami. But the fact that you can fight toe to toe with these guys is because you have what's called Oracle cells in your body. At least some of the god eaters do. I think they're called I was gonna say new types, but I can't remember. If that's a Gundam thing. That's the reason why you can fight toe to toe with these guys on a pretty even playing field. Except for that guy, he got super eaten. But Aragami are made up entirely of Oracle cells. So like they're like a highly evolved being, and I guess they survive off eating humans. So like the entire world is sort of has only like a few like safe zones per region. It sounds like we're in the Far East branch right now. So there's a lot of them. I think I want to take out this guy. Oh no! Stop, camera, please. Camera. I think these guys. Ah, shit. These guys support them. I can. Oh, my camera, please. I think he's dead. Yeah, that one's dead. Hey, did I get a power boost? Hey, what happened to my power boost, man? Hey, there's a lot of them. I don't remember this mission in the PSP version. Though, in light of the anime, they might be making more scenes like the anime. Damn, man. Stop shoot. Oh, that guy shoots stuff. That's what he does. I forgot. Get back here! Alright. Take this nerd. Yeah! Get some. You can't run away. I gotta go help Soma, though. Can I jump that? Yes, I can. Nope. not with the jumping. Ah, what the? Ah, you asshole! Stop shooting me, dude. Oh, how did he do that? I want that laser sword thing. There we go. Here we go. Ready for this? Yeah. Oh, I didn't get the special shot. How do I get the special? Oh! Whoa! Okay, let's see. If I can't... did I beat him? Oh, there's another one. There's another one over this way. Ah, he's in Sector K. Alright. Oh, he's going the other way. What a... You're not being very... he's being more cooperative than I'd like, though. Or than I expected, I mean. Where is he? He should be... There he is. Oh, how did he get away from me? Alright, he's dead. I'm gonna shoot him. I'm gonna shoot this asshole. What are you gonna do? I got a gun. GG. Alright, let's eat him. The spoils of victory. The spoils of giant monster war. Oh boy. My nose is all runny. But yeah, I mean, I guess I overhyped this game, but I do really enjoy it. I love the setting. I love just hunting giant monsters like this. It is kind of dark as far as hunting games go, I guess. I think it's a little more gory than Monster Hunter. But I want that ability. I want that giant glowing laser sword, man. He had that in Project Crosszone also. Damn, I want that. That's cool. Oh well. I hope I didn't oversell the game for you all, but I really do like this game a lot. And I... In that top 10 video I ended up trashing, this game, like I said, topped my list, and for good reason, mostly because prior to yesterday, this game had little to no chance of coming to the United States because of its low sales of the PSP version. I got mail, apparently. Because of low sales and pretty not-so-great reviews. Honestly, it might not even be reviewed well when it comes back for localization, but the fact that it is enough for me to be happy. If you want to support the game, you can still definitely import it. I mean, the God Eater Resurrection and God Eater 2 Rage Burst is coming stateside in the summer, they said, of 2016. But if you don't want to wait that long, I'm sure there's some kind of translation guide you can find out there, or you can just get... Actually, I don't think they sell the PSP version anymore on Vita. Well, I mean, I'm sure there's some kind of translation guide you can get and play the game even, like, on your own terms. Ooh, I finally like the second set of missions. Nice. But yeah, so I guess that'll be it for this video. Thanks so much for watching, and thanks so much for supporting God Eater or just having a passing curiosity. It's a really awesome game. Definitely, if I don't think pre-orders are open yet, but as soon as they are, you might want to consider, if you're interested, you definitely want to consider pre-ordering it. I don't think they haven't announced if it's going to be a retail version or if it's going to be if it's going to be digital only. But honestly, just pre-order if you can. It's really fun. I'm sorry if I'm overselling it, but it's a really, I don't know, I really like this game. So, alright, thanks for dealing with my ramblings, but I'll see you guys next time in some other video. So, see you guys later. Bye.